welcome to everyone. How wonderful it is to have so many here today. And as we come together in this sacred space, as we come together as family, as a body of Christ, we pray in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
My dear friends, at the end of Mass, it's my privilege to bestow upon all gathered here the apostolic blessing, which includes a plenary indulgence. I invite all of you to repent of your sins and dispose yourselves to share in this special opportunity to bring about restoration and reparation, confident that the Father hears us. And so now, my sisters and brothers, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. Lord Jesus, you have shown us the way to the Father. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you have given us the consolation of the truth. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you are the good shepherd leading us into everlasting life. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May the Blessed Mary, Ever Virgin, the Holy Apostles Peter and Paul, and all the saints assist you with their merits and prayers. May the Almighty and Merciful Lord forgive you and free you from all your sins. May he help you persevere in faithfulness, penance, good example, and sincere charity, and lead you to everlasting life.
Amen. Amen.
Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Jeremiah. The days are coming, says the Lord, when I will make a new covenant with the house of Israel and the house of Judah. It will not be like the covenant I made with their fathers, the day I took them by the hand to lead them forth from the land of Egypt. But this is the covenant which I will make with the house of Israel after those days, says the Lord. I will place my law within them and write it upon their hearts. I will be their God, and they shall be my people. No longer will they have need to teach their friends and relatives how to know the Lord. All, from the least to the greatest, shall know me, says the Lord. The word of the Lord.
A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, strive eagerly for the greatest spiritual gifts, but I shall show you a still more excellent way. If I speak in human and angelic tongues, but do not have love, I am a resounding gong or a clashing cymbal. And if I have the gift of prophecy and comprehend all mysteries and all knowledge, if I have all faith so as to move mountains, but do not have love, I am nothing. If I give away everything I own, and if I hand my body over so that I may boast, but do not have love, I gain nothing. Love is patient, love is kind, it is not jealous, is not pompous, it is not inflated, it is not rude, it does not seek its own interests, it is not quick-tempered, it does not brood over injury, it does not rejoice over wrongdoing, but rejoices with the truth. It bears all things, believes all things, hopes all things, endures all things. Love never fails. The word of the Lord.
Be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
There was a wedding in Cana in Galilee, and the mother of Jesus was there. Jesus' disciples were also invited to the wedding. When the wine ran short, the mother of Jesus said to him, "They have no wine." And Jesus said to her, "Woman, how does your concern affect me? My hour has not yet come." His mother said to the servers, "Do whatever he tells you." Now there were 6 stone water jars there for Jewish ceremonial washings, each holding 20 to 30 gallons. Jesus told them, "Fill the jars with water." so they filled them to the brim. Then he told them, draw some out now and take it to the head waiter. So they took it. And when the head waiter tasted the water that had become wine, without knowing where it came from, although the servers who had drawn the water knew, the head waiter called the bridegroom and said to him, everyone serves the good wine first, and then when people have drunk freely, an inferior one. But you have kept the good wine until now. Jesus did this as the beginning of his signs at Cana in Galilee, and so revealed his glory, and his disciples began to believe in him. The Gospel of the Lord. Once again, I just certainly want to welcome each and every one of you here today on this beautiful day that our God has given us, this beautiful celebration that we have in this beautiful sacred space of ours. Especially all of those of you who are celebrating your wedding anniversaries, your family and friends, whether they're here with you or far away. Certainly welcome the members of the Diocesan Chorale, all the ministers here, Deb Lieberg, our diocesan chancellor, and my assistant and her team of helpers. Father Andrew isn't here, but, well, that's probably David's cell phone, not his. So hopefully the cell phone's working. The Facebook feed, those joining online. Certainly the cathedral staff. What a wonderful event we gather for. What a pleasure, what a privilege it is to be here. Now, those of you who know me pretty much at all know that I'm not good with names. Even before coming a bishop, I couldn't remember names, and it hasn't gotten any better. I was filling in at a parish a few weeks ago, and the priest had planned to do a blessing at the end of Mass for an engaged couple, as their big day was getting ever closer. The time came for the blessing, and for the life of me, I couldn't remember either one of their names. I'd lost the paper that I'd written them on. And in a bit of a panic, I announced, will those wanting to be married please come forward? And immediately, 9 single women, 3 widows, 4 widowers, and 6... I was going to transition from there to say, well, we're not here with those who want to be married today, but those who are. I wasn't sure that sounded right. So in the words of one of my sisters, oh dear, today we do gather in celebration of your wedding anniversaries. 87 couples responded. Of those, 6, for various reasons, are not able to be here with us, but 81 of you are. Many of you are celebrating your 40, 50, 60th anniversary. There's 3 couples that are in their 70s, with the longest being 75. Regardless, though, of what number of anniversary this is for you, it is special, it is important. And my dear friends, from the bottom of my heart, thank you for being here today. Thank you for the gift, the witness that you are, that your marriage is. I hope and I pray that you know how important you are. Be assured of my prayers for you. And again, thank you for the privilege, the pleasure of celebrating with you. Back on May 25th of 2018, Pope Francis in a homily pointed out that marriage is perhaps the greatest thing God created in the 7 days of creation. He went on to point out the facts that since man and woman are created in that image and that likeness of God, marriage is also likewise an image of God. And so today we gather here to celebrate your wedding anniversary. We celebrate how you are that image and likeness of God in our world, to your families, your marriage is so much more than a civil license that you had to get married. Today we celebrate the supernatural reality that instead of a contract of the marriage license, we celebrate that covenant. A covenant of eternal supernatural promise between the two of you and between you and God. And that supernatural eternal promise that God made to you to be with you forever. We celebrate your promise to be faithful to each other and to the truths of the Catholic Church and to the desires that God has for you in this life. And we celebrate God's promise to bless your union, to grace it with an overabundance of joy, the very best of wine, to give you that divine strength that you need in tough times, and again, to be ever always with you. In the Gospel today, we heard the story of the wedding feast at Cana. And if Pope Francis is right, and marriage is the greatest thing God created in the 7 days of creation, what better occasion could there be than a wedding feast to announce the new messianic age that Jesus ushers in? The arrival of the new Adam, our Savior, and that ultimate outpouring of our God's love, mercy, and grace. Only God's own hand can make a marriage, a wedding, any better. And Jesus does just that as he changes that water into wine. And not just a little bit of wine to get through the event, but that wine overflowing 120 to 160 gallons. A sign of that abundance of God's love, God's mercy, that joy of the kingdom of heaven, the kingdom of our God. Jesus may not have been at your wedding reception changing water into wine for you, but as with a couple in the gospel, you invited him to your wedding. And he, our God, was present there on your wedding day, and again has been present to you every single day of your lives since. On the day that you were married, as you held each other's hands, our Lord wrapped his hands around your hands as that sign, that strength, that promise. And as you spoke your wedding vows to each other, God promised to give you that grace and strength that you needed to be true to all that you vowed to each other that day, and to become that sacramental sign for all the world to see of that love the Lord has for his church and for each of us, a love that is permanent and life-giving and everlasting. There's an old saying that goes something to the effect that marriage is made in heaven, but it's lived out here on earth. On your wedding day, Jesus didn't promise that it would always be the party, that it would all be sunshine, roses. What he did promise, though, was to be with you and to give you that grace and strength needed as you face the challenges, the crosses and the disappointments that would come your way. How important that love that St. Paul spoke about in the second reading is in living out your wedding here on earth. St. Paul speaks of a love that is patient and kind, never rude or self-serving or quick-tempered, but rather a love that bears all things, believes all things, hopes all things, and endures all things. The love that St. Paul talks about is that presence of our God, that God who is love. I would guess that for most of you, love or your married life hasn't always been fun or easy. But you've held on to each other through it all, and you refuse to take the easy way out. You refuse to quit trying, and so today we rejoice and celebrate the witness you are, first to your families, and then to us, and to all the world. And so, my dear friends, how much more than ever before the church needs, our nation needs, the whole world needs that witness that you are. That witness to what our God intended from that moment of creation, from the beginning of time. The example of married life and love, that beautiful witness of being holy families, are gifts that profoundly enrich the church and all of society. So as you continue your journey as husband and wife, know that it most likely will not be all sunshine and roses, but also know that those gifts, those blessings, those beautiful memories of life lived will also increase, will also strengthen you, will also continue to remind you of that love that brought you together in the first place. So as you continue your journey, continue to be kind and forgiving to each other. Continue to put each other first. And continue to look to our Lord God, and especially the gift of the Eucharist and the Holy Mass, and allow him to nurture and to nourish you, to give you that strength and that courage to be able to continue to witness to God's love, to be that witness to God's love that you have been for however many years it's been. May the Lord continue to watch over, guide, guard, bless, protect each and every one of you. And may each of you couples share many, many more happy wedding anniversaries. God bless you, and thank you again for being here. Thank you for who you are. Thank you for allowing God into your lives, making you that witness of his love, his presence that you are.
By your goodness,
I took as my right.
comfort in adversity and your support in prosperity. May he fill your home with his blessings. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Increase and sanctify, O Lord, the love of these your servants, who once gave each other these strings as a sign of faithfulness, that they may always grow in the grace of the sacrament. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Stand for the prayers of the faithful. Let us call upon the mercy of God, the Almighty Father, for in his most provident plan willed that the history of salvation be signified in marital love and fidelity.
Holy Father, who are called faithful, requiring and rewarding the observance of your covenant, be pleased to fill with your blessings these your servants who celebrate the anniversary of their marriage. We pray to the Lord.
Amen.
Holy Father, who with the Son and the Holy Spirit enjoy from eternity perfect oneness of life and communion of love, grant that these, your servants, may always remember and faithfully keep the covenant of love they made in the sacrament. We pray to the Lord.
Amen.
Holy Father, who in your providence order all the experiences of human life so as to lead the faithful to share in the mystery of Christ, grant that these, your servants, serenely accepting both good times and bad, may strive to cling to Christ and live for him alone. We pray to the Lord.
Amen.
Holy Father, who willed that the partnership of marriage should be an example of Christian living, grant that all married couples see the domestic church formed by their union as a potent witness for the larger church throughout the world, helping it to grow in both size and in wisdom. We pray to the Lord.
Amen.
Holy Father, whose ears are attentive to our cry, listen to the special intention of Francis, our Pope, that through the sacrament of marriage and prayer, we may help all who have strayed from the faith rediscover the merciful closeness of the Lord and the beauty of the Christian life. We pray to the Lord. Holy Father, we pray for those who have died and for those who grieve the death of a spouse. May our faith in the death and resurrection of Christ be a light to those who have gone before us and a comfort for those who await the open door of the kingdom. We pray to the Lord.
Lord,
hear our prayer. Holy Father, through an increase in faith, may we truly see that our special intentions for which we now pray. Will always be answered according to your divine will. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
O God, whose plan, family, life has its firm foundation, hear with compassion the prayers of your servants, and grant the following example of the Holy Family, they may praise you without end in the joy of your house, through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
Please be seated for the preparation of the gifts.
Thank you.
Let us pray, my sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. O God, who made blood and water flow from the side of Christ as a sign of the mysteries of human rebirth, be pleased, we pray, to receive the offerings we make in thanksgiving on behalf of your servants and endow their marriage with your many gifts, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
He is
truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, for you willed that the human race, created by the gift of your goodness, should be raised to such high dignity that in the union of husband and wife you might bestow a true image of your love. For those you created out of charity, you call to the law of charity without ceasing and grant them a share in your eternal charity. And so the sacrament of holy matrimony, as the abiding sign of your own love, consecrates the love of man and woman through Christ our Lord. Through him, with the angels and all the saints, we sing the hymn of your praise, as without end we acclaim. You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy, and you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become for us the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For in the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven. And as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit may be become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, and with all the saints, on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May the sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis our Pope, me your unworthy minister, with the order of bishops and all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned before you. Strengthen, we pray, in the grace of marriage, these servants whom you have brought here today, that under your protection they may always be faithful in their lives to the covenant they sealed in your presence. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters and to all who are pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of our glory. Through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. Praise you, O God, we bless you, creator of all things, who in the beginning made man and woman that they might form a communion of life and love. We also give you thanks for graciously blessing the family life of your servants so that it might present an image of Christ's union with the church. Therefore, look with kindness upon them today, and as you have sustained their communion amid joys and struggles, renew their marriage covenant each day, increase their charity, and strengthen them in the bond of peace, so that they may forever enjoy your blessing through Christ our Lord. Amen. Lord Jesus Christ said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other a sign of Christ's peace. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter into my room, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed. Just one real brief announcement. We do have low gluten hosts if anyone has gluten intolerance, so just let us know. O God, who have graciously welcomed these married couples to the table of your family, grant that they may continue to grow in strong and eager communion with each other, so that by your gift they may be united until they reach the heavenly banquet. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
I invite everyone to be seated.
Thank you.
celebrating 35 years of marriage, Howard and Lynn Neat.
Thank you.
Once again, just want to say how wonderful it is to have everybody be here, and thank you again for the gift that you are, the gift that you continue to be, that witness to that love of our God and that sanctity of the sacrament of marriage. Let's just show our thanks and appreciation to all the couples, the choir, the chorale, for all those who have helped make today possible. Now, one other quick announcement. There is a lunch being served downstairs immediately after we get done here. If you go out the back here to the to my left, to your right as you're facing me, there's an elevator if need be, and to the other direction there's steps going down. So, you know, again, certainly hopefully everybody can come down and enjoy a wonderful meal.
The Most Reverend Father, James C. Powers, by the grace of God and the Apostolic See, Bishop of this Holy Church of Superior, will give the apostolic blessing with a plenary indulgence in the name of the Roman Pontiff to all present who are in a state of grace, having the interior disposition of detachment from sin, having sacramentally confessed their sins, having received Holy Communion, and by praying for the intentions of our Pope Francis, our Bishop James, and for Holy Mother Church. May we all strive by holiness of life to walk in full communion with her.
Please rise. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Blessed be the name of the Lord.
Now and forever.
Our help is in the name of the Lord.
Who made heaven and earth.
May God, the all-powerful Father, grant you his joy. Amen. May the only begotten Son of God stand by you with compassion in good times and in bad.
Amen.
Amen.
And may the Holy Spirit always pour forth love into your hearts.
Amen.
Amen.
And through the intercession of the blessed apostles Peter and Paul, may Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Amen.
Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you.
Heavenly Father, as we continue in your presence, we give thanks for all your gifts, your blessings. We certainly thank you for the gift of this day, for the gift of these couples, the families, the witnesses they are. We pray, Father,